Good morning, students. This is 11th standard botany video class, video 1. In this video, we are going to start the new lesson, that is Plant Kingdom, chapter 2. Dear students, in the previous chapter, we have seen different classification of plant kingdom, such as virus, bacteria, fungi, under their classification, salient feature of different classes, economic importance, and also life cycle of two important fungi also we have seen in the previous video class. In this video, we are going to see the plant kingdom classification, under their characteristic feature, life cycle of organism, different methods of reproduction, their habitat, habit, and their structural and functional organization of organisms. Dear students, this is the chapter outline. First topic is classification of plants, life cycle patterns in plants, algae, bryophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperm, and angiosperm. So this is the chapter outline which we are going to see in this lesson. Dear students, all over the world, the organisms, that is living organisms, which is divided into plants and animals, based on their food material, that is mode of nutrition, locomotion, presence or absence of cell wall, that is classified into bacteria, fungi, algae, bryophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperm and angiosperms are included in the plant kingdom. All over the world, the kingdom which is divided into plant kingdom and animal kingdom. Plant kingdom divided into these topics: bacteria, fungi, algae, bryophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperm and angiosperm. Recently, some of the inventions is also proved that the molecular characteristic feature of bacteria and fungi is also segregated to put forward bacteria and fungi into separate kingdom. Dear students, see the diagram. The diagram which are containing the microscopic organism such as bacteria under the microscope. So this molecular structure only separate the bacteria and fungi into separate kingdom, that is Monera and kingdom fungi. But in oldest classification, there is no separation for bacteria and fungi. All of them put together in the kingdom Plantae. Dear students, study of plants is known as botany. You already know that one. Botany is the oldest science to identify the different kinds of plants and their characteristic feature. Plants are the important organ to produce food material for other organisms. That process was identified by most of the scientists in the oldest period. Not only food material, the plants which are giving clothing, medicine and shelter. So that plants are named as producers. Other organisms depend upon the plants for their food material and their shelter. These plants which are doing important process, it's said to be photosynthesis. By using the materials such as sunlight, water, carbon dioxide and chlorophyll pigment. They are producing the food material is known as starch or carbohydrate by the process is called photosynthesis. So dear students, these plants not only supplying the food material to the all living organism and also they are capturing the carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. We all know that one, carbon dioxide is the poisonous gas which is present in the atmosphere. So these plants which are storing these kinds of carbon dioxide and reduce the amount in the atmosphere, and also they are reducing the problem caused by carbon dioxide which is known as greenhouse gas, and also this carbon dioxide increase the global temperature. So these global temperatures are reduced by the plants capturing the carbon dioxide for the process is called photosynthesis. So that plants are showing variability in the nature. They are also ranging from microscopic algae to macroscopic highly advanced plants known as angiosperms. So these variations, dear students, plants which are showing the different variation based upon the size, shape, habit, that is character, habitat, living place and reproduction. And also plants which are made up of cell wall, which are showing variability in form and structure. That is given in the table, total number of plants group in the world and India. Plant group algae 40,000, India 7,357, bryophytes 16,000, India 2,700, pteridophytes 12,000, in India 1,289, gymnosperm 1,012, in India 79, angiospermic plant 268,600, in India 18,386. So these are all the different variability of the number of the plant group all over the world and India. So this is the total number of plant groups which is present in world and India. Dear students, next we are going to see classification of plants. Totally plants are classified into embryophyta. This embryophyta which is divided into bryophyta and tracheophyta. Totally widely accepted plants are now include, what is that one? Embryophyta. This embryophyta which is divided into two, bryophyta and tracheophyta. Then further it is divided into pteridophyta and spermatophyta. Spermatophyta which is divided into gymnospermae and angiospermae. So this is the general classification of plants. Now we are going to see the classification with a diagram. Kingdom plantae which is divided into two subkingdom, cryptogames and phanerogames. Cryptogames are otherwise known as non-flowering plants. That means they do not produce flower and also no seed. That's why it is said to be non-flowering and non-seed producing plants. Another subkingdom is phanerogame. That is, they are named as flowering plants and also seed producing plants. That is, first one, cryptogames means there is no flower. Phanerogames means they are producing the reproductive organ is said to be flower. Then the cryptogames again divided into three division: algae, bryophyta, pteridophyta. Then phanerogame divided into gymnosperm and angiosperm. Then these algae, bryophytes and pteridophytes, which are again divided into first one algae, they are most probably living in the water, that is said to be aquatic habitat. Some of them unicellular, some of them in the form of colonies. Thalloid, that is filamentous structure or ribbon like structure. Parenchymatous. So these are all the first division of algae. Second one, bryophyta. They are named as first terrestrial habitat of organization. So before that, all the plants are living in the water only. There is no plants on the land region. After that, the bryophytes are named as first land living plants. That's why they are given terrestrial colonization. Terrestrial means living on the ground. These bryophytes are divided into two: liverworts and mosses. Then pteridophyta. They are also said to be the terrestrial mode of colonization, divided into club mosses, hostales. Hostales means a plant look like in the form of hostale, named equisetum, ferns and other plants. Now coming to the phanerogame, divided into gymnospermae and angiospermae. Gymnospermae, they are producing seeds, but that seeds are, we can able to see with our naked eye. Namma kannala paaka mudiyum. But normally, in angiospermic plant, for example, mango is there. Mango seed we cannot see with our naked eye. After opening the mango fruit only, we can able to see the seeds, isn't it? That is said to be closed type. But in gymnospermic plant, the seeds are naked. They are directly produced on the bark of a tree or branches of a tree. That is said to be naked seeds. Divided into three types: cycads, conifers and needles. Last one, angiosperm. The seeds are located inside the seed coat. That is known as closed seeded plant. Divided into two: dicot and monocot. So dear students, this is the classification of plant kingdom. Dear students, plants which are showing different mode of life cycles. So one of the pattern is said to be alternation of generation. So what is alternation of generation? In their life cycle, plants which are showing two mode of phases or generation, that is said to be alternation of generation. So this is divided into two. One is said to be gametophytic phase. Another one is the sporophytic phase. Gametophytic phase means they are producing the gametes. Sporophytic phase means they are producing the plant parts. For example, stem, root, leaf, like that. That is said to be the sporophytic phase. Gametophytic phase means they are producing male gamete, that is pollen grains, female gamete, that is gynoecium, that is ova, egg or ova. So these are all the two phases which is common in all the plants. So this two generation which are showing in the plant life cycle, that is named as alternation of generation. Dear students, the gametophytic phase is always haploid. That is, it contains n number of chromosomes. That is haploid. With it, sporophytic phase is diploid in condition. That means 2n number of chromosomes. This is said to be alternation of generation. It's an important book back 2-mark question. What is alternation of generation? Alternation of the haploid gametophytic phase, bracket N, with diploid sporophytic phase, bracket 2N, during their life cycle is known as alternation of generation. So, these plants which are showing different life cycle, first one is the haplondic life cycle. So, based upon the number of the chromosome, which phase is showing the haploid and which one is the diploid? Gametophytic phase is haploid. Sporophytic phase is, what is that one? Diploid. See, first one, haplondic life cycle. Dear students, in this life cycle, which one is dominant means gametophytic phase is dominant. And also photosynthetic, that means green in color. And independent, that means they are not depending upon the food material or shelter or water maybe to the other organisms. Whereas the sporophytic phase is represented by the zygote. So sporophytic phase is named as, what is that one? Zygote. Zygote undergoes meiotic cell division to produce haploid spores. This condition is called a haplondic life cycle. So gametophyte is dominant, photosynthetic and independent, whereas sporophytic phase is represented by the zygote. That means, zygote means the number of chromosomes, what is that one? 2N. Gametophytic phase is, what is the number of chromosomes? N. But when comparing to these two, gametophytic phase is dominant. So this will occur most probably in lower plants. Example, algae. Algae only showing gametophytic phase is the dominant and also independent. But the sporophytic phase is depending upon the gametophyte. That type of life cycle is known as haplondic life cycle. Example, Wallbox and Spirogyra. Dear students, see the diagrammatic representation. This is the haplondic life cycle, which contains two phases or generation. One is the gametophyte, which is N number of chromosome. Another one is the red color, which is known as sporophytic, which is diploid, that is 2N number of phases. So first, see the gametophytic phase color, which is green in color. So that is photosynthetic and also independent, dominant. See the ratio also in the circle. 1/3 is only sporophytic, remaining the three phases are known as the gametophyte. That's why they told dominant, independent and also photosynthetic. That's why they given green in color. Yeah. So this gametophyte, which is haploid, produce the two type of gametes, male and female gamete. Production of gametes is known as gametogenesis. I hope you have all studied in zoology. Gametogenesis means formation of gametes. Both the gametes are haploid, fused together to form a diploid zygote. That fusion is known as fertilization or syngamy. This diploid zygote is undergo meiotic cell division to form a haploid spores. So the life cycle, which is start from the haploid spores, that's why this life cycle is known as haplondic life cycle. Because haplondic life cycle only, which are dominant when you are compared to the diploid zygote condition. That's why this life cycle is known as haploidic life cycle. Dear students, in the previous paragraph we have seen gametophyte is the haploid, dominant, independent and also photosynthetic. Example, algae, we have seen two examples, Volvox and Spirogyra. The other example of bryophytes and pteridophytes is also given here. In the bryophyte is also, gametophyte is the dominant and independent phase. And it alternates the short-lived multicellular sporophytic phase. This sporophytic phase is totally or partially depend upon the gametophyte. Why it is depending? The sporophyte is not having the green color pigment, so they are unable to prepare the food material, isn't it? But the gametophyte is, what is that one? Dominant photosynthetic. So this sporophyte, which are depending upon the gametophytic phase, either totally or partially, that is said to be another haploidic life cycle of bryophytes. Next one, pteridophytes. This is somewhat different from the algae and the bryophytes. Here, the sporophytic phase is the independent, not depending upon the, what is that one? Gametophyte. Okay, yeah? So independent phase, it alternates another generation. What is another generation? Gametophyte, isn't it? It alternates with multicellular saprophytic. Saprophytic means the organism which is taking food material from the dead and the decayed matter. That is said to be saprophytic. Or some of them are autotrophic, preparing their own food material. Independent, that means they are free, not depending upon the gametophyte. Short-lived gametophyte. So, the pteridophytes which are showing independent sporophytic phase, and also the gametophytic phase also, what is that one? Independent, multicellular, saprophyte or autotrophic. But their life is very short-lived. So, these are all the two alternation of generation in pteridophytes and their gymnosperm. Dear students, in the previous para, we have seen haploidic life cycle. That means a gametophyte is dominant, photosynthetic, independent, and also haploid in condition. But sporophyte is very short-lived, diploid in the condition. The diploid zygote undergo meiotic cell division, produce haploid spores, so that the haploid phase only dominant. But in the another life cycle named diploidic life cycle, the sporophytic phase, whatever may be sporophytic phase, what is it? Like a diploid only, isn't it? Here, the sporophytic phase is dominant, photosynthetic, that is green in color, and also independent. But the gametophytic phase is made up of with single to few celled gametophyte. So these gametes are fuses to form zygote, which developed into a diploid sporophyte. Example, fucus, gymnosperm and angiosperm. So the sporophytic phase is, what is that one? Diploid in condition. Gametophyte is haploid. So here the sporophyte only dominant and independent. So this type of life cycle is known as diploidic. Because the life cycle starts from the, what is that one? Diploid sporophytic phase. That is said to be diploidic life cycle. The last type is haplodiploidic life cycle. So this type of life cycle, which is present in both bryophytes and pteridophytes, which are showing intermediate stage of aplondic and diplondic life cycle. Both the phases are multicellular, but they differ in their dominant phase. So which one is dominant, we don't know. But these bryophytes and pteridophytes, which are showing haplodiplondic life cycle, both the phases are multicellular, but dominant phase is different. That is given in the example of pteridophyte and bryophytes. Bryophytes, the gametophyte is dominant and independent. So the sporophyte is partially dependent. We have already seen, but once again we are going to see this one. Pteridophytes, sporophyte is the dominant and independent. At the same time, gametophyte is also multicellular, autotrophic and independent. But its life is very short. So this is the example of haplodiplondic life cycle, which is seen in the bryophytes and pteridophytes. So dear students, I hope have you all understood different life cycle of plants. Haplondic life cycle, diplondic life cycle, haplodiplondic life cycle, and also alternation of generation. What is alternation of generation? A plant life cycle which are showing an haploid gametophytic phase with a diploid sporophytic phase is known as alternation of generation. Dear students, see the diagram which is showing the diplondic life cycle. So the diplondic life cycle, which is, what is that in ungalku, which occupies the larger surface. So the sporophyte is dominant and also independent. They are producing haploid gametes by the process called gametogenesis, and fuses together two gametes to form a diploid zygote, that process known as syngamy. So the diploid zygote only which are producing the diploid sporophytic plants. At the same time, the gametophyte is also independent, photosynthetic, that is, which is green in color, isn't it? Photosynthetic and multicellular. So this type of life cycle is known as diplondic life cycle. The last type is haplodiplondic life cycle, which are showing 50% or 50% both the life cycle, haplondic and diplondic life cycle. So here the gametophytic phase is also green in color, photosynthetic. They are producing gametes from the gametophyte, which is haploid. So these gametes are fused together by a process called syngamy, produce diploid zygote. They are produced the diploid sporophytic phase. This sporophyte diploid produce spores, undergo meiotic cell division. They are producing the haploid spores, isn't it? The diploid sporophytic phase undergo meiotic cell division to produce haploid spores. Then the gametophytic phase is taken place. So half of the life cycle which are showing haplondic and diplondic condition or alternation of generation. So this life cycle is known as haplodiplondic life cycle. Dear students, these three diagram, haplondic, diplondic and haplodiplondic life cycle, is very very important. 2 mark and 3 mark diagram, kindly note it down in your textbook. So up to this we have seen different life cycle pattern of plants. Dear students, now entering into the different topic of plant kingdom. First one is the unicellular organism which is living in the water is named as algae. So most of the algae which are present in the marine water, that is sea water, some of them living in the fresh water like ponds, lakes and rivers. So these algae which are showing different variation in their structure, function, organs which is present inner side of the algal body, cell wall nature, mode of reproduction, mode of nutrition, everything they are showing the variation. That's why we are going to see in this video class. Dear students, after this I conclude my video. Remaining we will see in the next video class. God bless you. All the best, children.